I'm Mark Evans. I'm Senior Curator of Natural Sciences here at Leicester Museums. One of our key objects is a plesiosaur that we have this nickname for called the Barrow Kipper. Barrow Kipper, well, the Barrow bit is because it's from Barrow-Upon-Soar, which is up to north of Leicester, up towards Loughborough. The Kipper part is interesting, and as far as I know, it's because in Barrow village there's a traffic island at the top of what they call Jerusalem Hill. And back in the 50s, on this island, they built a little monument. And this monument has a stylized representation of the plesiosaur on it. And because of the way it's been done, it's sort of splayed out with its ribs sticking out, and it's of legs like that. And it looks a bit like a kipper. It has a proper scientific name as well, and that's Romaliosaurus megacephalus. The megacephalus bit is just simply means that the head is quite large in relation to the body. So mega means large in Greek, and cephalus means head. The specimen was found in 1850 or 1851 up in Barrow-on-Soar in one of the quarries there, where they used to dig up the clay and use it for making bricks and also for making lime. Well, the specimen was bought from a farmer who was also a lime burner called William Lee, who lived in Barrow. And we assume, I suppose, that it was found in one of his quarries, but it may not have been. We don't actually know exactly which quarry it came from. And again, the date, we know that the museum bought it in 1851 with help from the Literary and Philosophical Society. And they provided some funds to help buy the specimen for the museum. I think back then in 1851 it cost £100, which actually is quite a lot of money for 1851. And as far as we know, it's been on display pretty much ever since in one form or another at the museum. But it's important that we display it because it's an important specimen, not least of course because it's local to Leicestershire and it has a certain appeal, I suppose, because of its local nickname and its local connections. But also it's important because it's what we call a type specimen, so it's a specimen that the actual species is founded upon. And so whenever anyone has to come and work out what this plesiosaur called Megacephalus actually is, they have to come here and look at the specimen we have in the museum because it's the one that the name is founded on. It's become a bit of a village emblem, and you can see it's on the sort of offices of the local parish council and things like that. So it seems that the people of Barrow have taken it to their hearts somewhat, and it's become a bit of a mascot for the village. So I think they have it have a special place for it, I think.
Probably the only village in the world, I should think, that has a plesiosaur for its village symbol. We have them on the bins and the seats that people sit on the lampposts, as well as the centre of the traffic island, which is such a feature of Barrow.
It's a reminder of the village history.
It's heritage, isn't it? And yeah, I think definitely it's a status.
I mean, we've lived now in the village for 25 years. And one of the first things that people said, have you seen the Barrow Kipper? So I said, where is the Barrow Kipper? So they told us one on the roundabout down here. And I think it does signify a lot of the past with the present in the village. And I know for a fact that when they have the village quizzes and they have loads of people here with sheets of paper, they're all walking down the street saying, where's the Barrow Kipper? So it's got a wide significance amongst many people, I think, not only in Barrow, but surrounding areas.
It's a welcoming sign as you come to the village after a visit somewhere else.
As the Barrow Kipper was found in 1851, of course 2011 will be the 160th sort of anniversary of it coming to the museum. So it's been here all that time, pretty much ever since the museum opened. So I'd like to think hopefully it'll be here, well, certainly for another 160 years, and certainly as long as there's a museum here, I hope there'll be the Barrow Kipper here. People will be able to come and see it on display in the museum.